Investing, it's all about making money, right? When people think about investing, this is what they usually think about. But what if we told you that investing can also be about making a positive impact on the world if you invest in what you believe in? In this series, we challenge some of the biggest misconceptions about investing by looking at true stories in investment history. And in the process, we teach you some of the basic ideas that every investor should know. We can make an impact with investing in many different ways and areas. Let's begin by looking at how a group of investors managed to use their power as shareholders to impact the policy of several big oil companies and put them on a greener course.
Follow this is a movement of green shareholders in big oil. So this sounds very counterintuitive, but we are convinced that we need big oil to speed up the energy transition, to make any chance to stop climate change.
Dutch activist Mark van Baal wanted oil companies to change their policies. So he came up with an out-of-the-box idea. He bought shares in one of the biggest oil companies in the world, Shell, and became a so-called activist investor.
The goal is that shareholders support and, if needed, force big oil to commit to the Paris Climate Agreement and shift their investments from looking for more oil and gas to looking for new business models in renewable energy.
So buy into the company, and kind of influence them from within.
Yeah, we prefer to be called green shareholders. We just have a fair ask, but in practice we are called activist shareholders because we really want to change companies for good. So the most important thing that happened in the last couple of years is that oil companies, one by one, accept responsibility for the emissions of their products. And that's a really big thing because before Follow This started, they didn't want to talk about that. They said, we're going to drive down our own emissions, but what our customers do with our products, that's not our responsibility. So if they keep on asking for oil and gas, we will keep on supplying oil and gas. And because shareholders started to vote for our climate resolution, which asked them to drive down emissions, not only of their operations, but also of their products, they said, okay, we're gonna drive down also the emissions of our products. And that's really crossing the Rubicon because then suddenly you have something to talk about.
Exxon shareholders elected two members of climate-focused investor group to serve on the company's board. Over 60% of Chevron shareholders voted in favor of a petition making Chevron responsible not just for their own emissions, but the emissions of the products they sell to customers as well.
So impact investing is all about investors using their voice to make an impact towards a better world. The amount of shares owned by an individual investor is usually not enough to actually affect a company's policy. But if enough shareholders band together, they can make their voices heard, like Follow This. But shareholder activism is not the only way to make an impact with investing. Because we have to remember, when we own stock of a particular company, we own a share of that company. And so, if you're an active investor, you can avoid the companies whose policies you don't support by not owning their stocks, or by simply targeting and buying the ones whose policies you do support.
We are at the Green Tech Festival in Berlin, and it's an event that I co-founded 3 years ago. I'm an early stage investor in Formula E, and the Formula E race here in Berlin, I was visiting the race, and I was like, it's such a pity that we don't like create a green consumer electronics show around the racetrack. Green Tech Festival stands for impact, and we want to generate impact by creating this global platform to unite the leading change makers in the world and also the leading green technologies and really create awareness, create partnerships, just accelerate the positive change. There's so many examples. One thing is vertical farming. Indoors, it's called Agrilution. Another one would be Rimac, which is the world's fastest electric car. And they're here and they just broke all the records. Mobility is one of our pillars. And so we also have the flying taxis. And I'm actually an investor as well in Volocopter and Lilium.
It can be hard to discover which companies are sustainable and how sustainable companies really are, which can be quite complex, especially if you realize that impact investing doesn't only mean green sustainable investing.
So there's a new term in finance with three letters. It's an acronym, ESG. E stands for environmental, S stands for social, and G stands for governance.
When it comes to the E of environmental, we think about managing resources like water and energy, but also emissions, innovation, and treatment of animals. When we consider the S of social, we think about the workforce, human rights, contributions to communities, and product responsibility. If we look at the G of governance, it's all about how companies are run. It's about company management transparency, shareholder interests, or corporate social responsibility.
Je kan ook bedrijven gaan uitsluiten. Gewoon omdat je zegt, nou, in mijn ideale toekomst is in ieder geval geen plek voor dit bedrijf. En dan gewoon niet daarin gaan beleggen. Je kan ook gewoon op die manier proberen een beetje duurzamer te gaan beleggen.
Nou, de meeste ETF's die doen dat op deze manier. Die doen gewoon uitsluiting. Een ETF zonder en met is geen er.
One of the most popular topics in investing right now is ESG. Investors like BlackRock, one of the largest investors in the world, has taken a note of that. And so they've done amazing things. They put pressure on companies to say, listen, your industry is one of the biggest pollutants across the world. What is your ESG plan? On top of that, they also increase access so that everyday consumers can invest in ETFs or index funds on environmentally sustainable companies.
And there's a lot of ETFs that have grouped together some of the most interesting established companies who are really part of this green revolution. And those ETFs have been performing extremely well.
Due to the rise of impact investing, we've seen a growth in popularity in ETFs that focus on ESG ratings. It's become an incentive for companies to do better when it comes to ESG. Being included in these popular ETFs means more demand for their stock, which means higher stock prices. But there's still room for improvement.
But what I think is sort of missing from all of this and in the discourse is that we focus on this term ESG and only focused on the E. And don't get me wrong, I love that we're moving towards a greener, more sustainable planet, of course. But there's also the S in ESG, which is, what are we doing towards social justice?
We've also become aware that it's important to understand that unless you carefully watch managers, that you have boards of directors that provide really good oversight, that companies might not be as well run as they could. So we want companies with strong boards to serve the interests of the underlying shareholders in particular, and other constituencies if possible.
Of course, you're wondering, does investing in ESG actually pay off? Or does investing in what you believe in mean you have to sacrifice possible financial returns? If we look at ETFs and compare ESG funds with standard funds, we barely see any difference in performance. This might be the reason why we've seen such a big increase in ESG-related ETFs in the past years, as well as the amount of money being invested in ESG-focused funds. Impact investing is paying off.
We want to show how sustainability now is also becoming very, very cool, and it's not any more a requirement to compromise, you know, to be more sustainable. But actually, the more sustainable solution is cooler, more efficient, sometimes even by now cheaper.
Volgens mij zijn er zelfs de laatste jaren zijn zelfs ETF's die duurzaam zijn, die presteren trouwens beter. Dus ik denk dat we die fase wel gepasseerd zijn, dat duurzaamheid meer een soort van charity idee heeft dan dat. En dat, ik denk dat we dat wel los kunnen laten.
I think we can wrap up our entire conversation with a quote from Maya Angelou that I just absolutely love. She says, do the best you can until you know better. But when you know better, do better.
Contributing is a human need for us all. And so for me, I can feel how in this path of investing and in this path of entrepreneurship, where I'm really starting to contribute more and more, I can feel proud, you know, and you feel fulfilled, and that brings happiness not only for others that hopefully we're improving their lives day to day, but also for myself. So that's wonderful.
For me, impact investing means that you try to influence companies and preferably the whole world in a positive way with your investment. I think every investor should be an impact investor.
Even though impact investing might still be developing, it's clear that modern investing is no longer just about risks and returns, but it can be about our values as well. So set your investing goals accordingly and line up your investment strategy with your hopes for the future.